Hi, folks. I'm very sorry for the delay in getting started. I had what could perhaps best be described as several technical issues getting up and going, which sucks royal balls. But hello and welcome to this week's Dishonored stream. Large chunks of my hair just got trapped in my headphones, which is great. Hello and welcome. This week we are going to be starting Dishonored 2, and as decided by the good folks on twitter.com, it's been decided that we're going to be playing as Emily, which doesn't surprise me. She's my choice as well. I really like her. As with Dishonored 1, I'm going to be going for as stealthy and as non-lethal as possible, just because that is the harder option. I'm also going to try and get all the collectibles. I would really like to do the Jin Josh lock without cheating. I know there's a way to save Skunnet, but that feels kinda crappy, so... But anyway, that's not for a while. Let's hop over to the GP, shall we? Actually, we got started eventually. Yeah, I am really sorry for the delay in getting started. It's just... technical issues all around. As is so often the case, please, as always, let me know if the game is too loud or too quiet and I can fuck about with it. I've sort of amended it to a level which works for me, but if it's coming across really badly on stream, feel free to yell at me and let me know. And otherwise, let's just hop straight in, shall we? Time for a new game. Glad to remember that I last finished this at 4 in the morning, my second playthrough. I must have been bored. 27th of May 2018, year before last, what was happening? I moved into my flat. Was that when I took holiday but couldn't go anywhere? Maybe. Whatever. We're gonna play on... medium. Let's do it. Today marks the anniversary of the death of Empress Jessamine Colton, assassinated 15 years ago. Visitors from across the Empire of the Isles are journeying to Dunwall Tower for the occasion. What else has happened? Mother to Emily, Empress to us all.
Celebrate the anniversary of an assassination. 15 years ago, in the middle of a plague that nearly destroyed Dunwall, a paid killer assaulted the palace where I was born and stabbed my mother in the heart. In the aftermath, the men who sent the assassin tried to use me as a pawn in a game of power. They would have succeeded, but my father, Corvo Atano, hunted them down and cut their conspiracy to pieces.
I didn't actually do much murder, so...
I, the ruler my mother wanted me to be. Now, we face a new crisis. A monster the papers are calling the Crown Killer has been picking off my enemies and dressing it up like my father and I are responsible. I don't know whether to get on a ship and sail to the opposite side of the world, or to have everyone around me executed.
Emily, those are not the only two options. I'm gonna have to fuck about with the settings. I'm gonna turn the music down slightly and turn the main volume up to get the dialogue a bit louder. Options, audio, master volume up, music volume down, speech volume is at 100, last effects are down. No, speech and video should be 100, but we'll see how that goes. I thought I had paused Pretzel, but apparently not. There we go. I'm gonna check that my bot is actually live as well. Oops, you know, it'd be great if I could type correctly. Thanks, MochiBot, you are alive. Okay.
Watch your step, Majesty.
I'm fangs.
I'm looking forward to all the ceremony today.
Your signet ring. There, you're ready.
Thank you, Alexei. Open the doors.
Who wants to hear a fun fact? So I got the fancy edition of this as a pre-order, as a birthday present.
All hail her Imperial Majesty.
For my 21st birthday.
Loyal subjects, we're going through a difficult time, but today we honor my mother, the late Jessamine Caldwin. May her memory survive through the ages.
Emily.
You look tired, Father.
Every year, I think the anniversary of Jessamine's death will be easier, but it never is.
I wish Mother was still the Empress. I don't think I'm very good at this.
You're still learning. Don't worry about the rabble-rousers, and we'll catch the Crown Killer, eventually.
People are saying it's you. That these assassinations are a misguided effort to protect me.
No. Someone's trying to make us look guilty by targeting your enemies.
I wish I could just run away from all this.
Sometimes you do. You think I don't know about your nights out on the rooftops?
All right, Dad.
The ceremony will be over soon.
Royal protector and father. I should have passed a law against that combination of titles years ago.
So a fun fact. I got the fancy edition of this as a pre-order for my 21st birthday. And then it came with a signet ring, which I wore quite often, and I wore...
Before we begin the day's observances, we have an unexpected visitor, the Duke of Cirkonos.
When I went to visit some...
The Duke is bringing special gifts.
That's intriguing.
Disgrace Luca Abel, Duke of Cirkonos!
Mechanical soldiers? Amazing.
These guys...
What is this, Ramsay? I didn't authorize those things.
Your Imperial Majesty and Royal Protector Corvo Atano, a native of our homeland.
The point is that I lost the signet ring.
On this sorrowful day, and gifts to remind you of our nation, the rising star on the southern horizon.
We thank you, Your Grace.
Save your thanks. For now, I give you the greatest gift of all, family. I present the
I've never been able to.
Jessamine Caldwin, your rightful empress. Delilah Caldwin.
Impossible.
My mother had a sister?
My dearest niece. Hello.
I love Delilah.
True.
My father was Emperor Uhorn Jacob Caldwin, and Jessamine was my younger sister. At the time of her death, I wasn't ready to make myself known to you, and I was forced to leave Dunwall. But now I'm home.
If you really are my mother's sister, you're welcome to stay as long as you like.
Little Sparrow, blackened by bad memories, I'm here to relieve you of your crown. My father's promise, whispered in secret so many years ago, is now fulfilled.
Watch your tongue. Emily Caldwin is the daughter of Empress Jessamine Caldwin.
Royal Protector, how naive to think you could get away with these murders. Living in my palace has protected you, but that's over. Hear me, all of you. Your rightful Empress has returned.
All hail the Empress Delilah, first of her name. Arrest Emily Caldwin and her father for the Crown Killer murder.
What?
Gross. Emily Caldwin, ruler of the Empire of the Isles, trained in stealth and combat by her father, Corvo Atano, or Corvo Atano, legendary royal protector to the Empress and figure of infamy from the time of the Rat Plague. Obviously, it's gonna be Emily.
Cast you in cold marble. Sweet girl, over time you'll come to love me. Perhaps someday you'll see me as the mother you lost. But until then, you'll be kept out of trouble.
I'll lock Lady Emily in her chambers, then I'll bring her to Coldwell prison until her trial.
I think Delilah's such an interesting character.
I lost it all when I was a boy, so now I wear this uniform and I send 20-year-olds out to patrol the Rose Gardens instead of drinking with the men from the shooting club.
Captain Ramsay, I heard shouting. Lady Emily, what happened?
I hate...
It'll be all Captain Mayhew.
So much.
No!
Well, that's the Royal Protector's fancy weapon. What kind of sword folds in half?
A good one.
There's a legend in the Tower Guard about the Empress's last resort, a safe room inside your chambers holding enough gold to buy a good-sized island. They say that this ring is one of the only two keys to exist.
Betrayed, once again, ow, by my own stuff.
Alexei. The throne room. Father. Nothing I can do alone. I need to get out of here.
Okay. F.
Sir, how long is it going to take, Captain Ramsay?
I want to read it, please.
Get your horses, Corporal Dial. Ramsay knows what he's doing. The man's moving up in the world.
Options. Controls, keyboard mapping. Which one's the one to interact? F.
He's old blood.
F. No, freight from Sakonos bound for Tivia is now routinely set upon by pirates, spoiled with blood lies. In addition to the loss of Tivian lives, be they crew, dock workers, or shopkeepers, there's material cost of the cargo itself which can barely be calculated. Things continue unchecked, we'll be forced to cease trading with Sakonos and perhaps even embargo ships on the southernmost island altogether. But this need not come to pass. Trade Commission is a reasonable body and has already considered remedies to ameliorate the situation. Seek the following: independent qualified inspectors at all ports, patrols to defend against pirates and smugglers, compensation for the previous and future losses. It is this remedies I wish to discuss with you in person at the earliest opportunity possible. So far, your staff resist our efforts to establish a definitive time for negotiations. Prompt them to action, Ms. Majesty, for your eagle to travel to Dunwall. Till we can sit down and discuss this in a civilized fashion, I send you our best. Demian Shurigan, Principal, Tivian Trade Commission. No? Face yet another murder, and I cannot remain silent on this matter. Strange, is it not, that all the victims are openly opposed to you? If not strange, then how very convenient. Is there anything you wish to tell me, Majesty? How can I be of advisor if you don't include me in this most sensitive of endeavours? Feel I must be the only person in Dunwall who doesn't know the truth about the Crown Killer. Don't leave me out in the cold. I remain just trusted servant and advisor, Leonora Helmswater. After the Royal Protector shakedown cruise, we'll launch the ISS Jessamine Coldwyn just before the anniversary of your mother's passing, pending your approval, of course. On the platform, we'll have a bottle of King's Water brandy tied to a long tether you release to swing against the hull. What you say during the ceremony is, of course, up to you, but here are some ideas to serve as food for thought. May brisk wind hurry to shores near and far. May you always shelter your crew from the perils of the terrible ocean. May you always sail for Gristle, true of heart and homeward bound. Anything else? Looks like that's it.
Should I just spin it and pick a place to hide for a while?
Probably.
I need time to think. These bastards are working with Ramsay and the Duke of Sirkonos.
Right, I need to. Options, controls, keyboard mapping. F. Yes. Oh, E.
The Hound Pit's pub. I can't believe it, but I actually miss those times. I used to hide frogs in this old grandfather clock to drive the housekeepers mad. I thought life was complicated back then.
Don't we all?
How many times have I looked at that skyline?
Right.
It feels like everything just changed.
I remember where to go. That's really annoying.
Delilah is some sort of witch. How is this possible?
You're all right. I was worried.
Hi.
Where's the royal protector?
There's a coup underway. My father is. He's imprisoned, for lack of a better word.
You've got to get out of the tower. Through your safe room.
Boy, howdy, do I want to?
Here today, down at the docks, looking for the royal protector. Find her. Get out of Dunwall.
Alexei, I'm sorry. Goodbye.
So yeah, I'm gonna... be as, stealthy as possible. I'd rather not murder if possible, but that may not be possible.
No time for that now.
Yep, they sure are.
I do know what it's like to be blamed for murders you didn't commit. But trust me, we'll find this crown killer, and they'll pay. Tomorrow is the anniversary of her death. A sad day for sure. But I want you to remember all that's happened over the last 15 years. You've held on to the throne, and you've done what you thought was right for the people of the Empire.
Really shouldn't have played Assassin's Creed just before this, because I'm getting confused between mechanics of this and mechanics of Assassin's Creed.
You're becoming the sovereign your mother wanted you to be, and I'm proud of you.
Thanks, I try my hardest. So loud. Anything else around here to nab? Nothing? Cool. Right. That's where I was. Who else is around here? Many terrible things. Things, rather, I should say. Anyone else? Nobody? Cool. I have a problem whereby I have to open up every cupboard, like, just in case. Because you never know. Dumbledore Citizens West, shock and furious yet another outspoken critic of Empress Emily Colden is met with a violent demise. Latest victim is none other than Ichabod Boyle, notable entrepreneur and supporter of the arts. Boyle recently wrote an opinion piece harshly criticising the Emperor for what he called a slipshod style of governance and a willful neglect of duties. Authorities convinced the crown killer is the culprit, given the gruesome details left at the crime scene. As Her Majesty's most outspoken adversaries fall by one by one to one to this notorious assassin, boldly ask, is it now the duty of the royal protector to murder all who dare criticise the throne? No, because that's called, a dictatorship, but... Yep.
Traitors.
They sure are, but that doesn't mean we're gonna kill them. We're just gonna... possibly break their neck a bit, but that's okay.
This reminds me of good times with friends, with Wyman. All gone now.
Can't believe Emily smokes the devil's lettuce. I'm gonna walk through here like a ghost, eating every bit of fruit that there is.
Off, we should have the time we need. Just stay here and stall anyone who comes by. I'll be back when I've searched the royal chambers, assuming I don't accidentally lock myself in this damn safe.
We'll cover for you if anyone comes.
Right. I need to remember where I want to go. I'm gonna hide in here, actually. And we'll ambush him when he comes up here. I think this is probably the safest option. He should be sort of split away from everyone then. Stop fucking about and get upstairs, you scrub lord. There he is. That motherfucker. What a tool. Okay, but also, I have to be petty, so... I into the bath with you. Enjoy your broken neck.
Anton Sokolov made this lock.
Okay.
Please. I spent so many nights in here after the rat plague.
Close the door. It would make me much less stressed if I could do that thing. Little glimpse of the void and dreams are described by those awoken from comas are not limited to a select few. In my interviews have gleaned that there is not a single citizen without such visions at one time or another. This then perhaps must be a real place, not folklore or mass delusion. Perhaps it exists deep below the earth or far above it. Perhaps it is right next to us but hidden. Some trick of the light or wondrous curtain bars us from fully knowing it, and we all but wait for a natural philosopher to unlock the phenomena to show us how to see it at will. But when so revealed, it will not be a fearsome place any longer, not the distant and special realm described in the myth of the outsider. It will be strange, yes, even unsettling. But nonetheless, it will be a new realm for us to explore and eventually conquer. What new treasures await us there? Are the lakes made of liquid diamond? The clouds of weightless silver gas? And what things we would learn? It is a common story. A person has stopped breathing, pinned down to carriage wheels, some other tragic happenstance, and it is thought to be dead. When the weight is removed, they make a quick recovery. Nonetheless, for a moment or two, this person was lost to us, lost to the world itself. But what they experience while in this temporary death? Darkness? Nothingness? No, indeed not. They tell us, as so many before have, that they are in a particular place, and can describe it vividly. Who amongst us does not know the place? Have we not all seen it in our dreams? This place we share in the farthest reach of our minds, the realm where nothing makes sense, where one is at once both lost and at home, the void. I have another fun fact about this, which just reading about this made me think about it, and it reminds me a lot of Dragon Age's Fade as well. I tend to have a lot of dreams about various things, but they're all set in like the same place, which is like an alternate sort of apartment that I live in. And it's really weird, the number of different sort of dreams that I have that are all set there. And I've never really been able to work out, like I can work out what the individual stress dreams are about, but I've never been able to work out what the idea of like being in a massive building that I don't feel right living in, and it doesn't feel like I should be there. Maybe that's like my void, you know, or my fate is this apartment. In one dream I had, it was above a restaurant, and one of the ways to get in was to like climb in through the floor of my apartment, but through the roof of the restaurant, and to get in I had to climb on top of someone's table. And I had that dream, and I woke up and I was like, okay, that's definitely a dream about making a fool of myself in public, because my stress dreams are horrendously.
This could be handy.
Sailor's blessing, they say. Carving itself is a practice from long back, passed from salty dogs to young greenhorns still finding their sea legs. In old times, sailors cut into the tusks of ice seals and into the arm-long fangs of the bears that roam the islets north of Tivia. Once the whaling trade began, the practitioners began engraving the bones of those great beasts, rendering charms that sing in the night and grant some small boon, increasing the lover's vigor or providing defense against pregnancy. Shocking fear. Okay.
The crown killer must be connected to all this, with the Duke and Delilah. I have a feeling I'll need these.
Probably. Tubes. Munch, 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 munch. Act of Rebellion, known Jessamine Cauldron, chose Corvo as a royal protector when Corvo was 19 and she was 12. He served at Loyalty's bodyguard, courier, and some say spy, before and after she was crowned empress. Though it was scandalous gossip at the time, it is said they began a love affair around 1823, when Jessamine was 18 and Corvo 25. The next chapter of Tana's life is like something out of a legend. During the time of the rat plague, when the empress fell, Corvo was accused of regicide and sentenced for execution. He was thrown into Coldridge prison and publicly reviled. He escaped and is part of a small conspiracy dedicated to throwing down the tyrannical Lord Regent. Corvo struck back at the people who killed the empress and who wronged him. As Lord Regent fell, the loyalist conspiracy turned on Corvo, poisoning him. Surviving through some inner resilience and the help of a friend, He located the true assassin, the Empress, and fought his way out of the flooded district. Kor eventually cornered the last of the loners on Kingsborough Island at the Burrows Lighthouse and rescued Emily, heir to the throne. The romantic involvement between Kor Votan and the Empress Jessamine Colton was a terribly kept secret, and thus it is widely held that Emily Colton is their daughter. Following the interregnum, Kor watched over Emily as she began to rule the Empire of the Isles. Thanks, Dad. Didn't want to wake you this morning. You'll forgive me since we must have said goodbye 100 times yesterday night. And the only chance I get to see you with the hair all with her way is while you're asleep. As soon as the sun rises, you'll put on your Empress face. It makes me happy that I know your real face, the one that laughs at silly rhymes. I don't want to go back to Morley, but I'm needed there. It'll be 4 more months before we see each other again. I'll miss you. And yes, I'll bring you some white leaf tobacco for your hookah. Lord Kohor, if you're reading this letter as per your royal protective functions, know that I'm joking and perfectly aware that white leaf tobacco is forbidden crystal. Take care, my darling Emily. Don't go falling from a rooftop. I love you, Wyman. Can't stop, won't stop, physically unable to stop. Parents were older at the time of his birth, and his father died in a lumber accident outside the city when Corvo was still young. Around that time, his only sibling and firstborn sister moved away to Morley, and the family subsequently lost all contact with her. Only 16, Corvo danced with the people of Karnaca when he entered and won the annual Blade Verbena. Spectators from all over Sikonos were thrilled to see someone so young and striking, from a working-class family, advance through duel after duel, eventually taking the prize. This unexpected outcome secured Corvo a junior officer ranking in the Grand Sikonan Guard. As a soldier, he was involved in a number of conflicts against organized criminal groups, rogue city-states within Sikonos, and pirate bands along the chain of islands, radiating east from Sikonos. Sent from his homeland at the age of 18 by the Duke of Sikonos, then Theodonos Abele, father of Luca Abele, Corvo was assigned to serve the Emperor in Dunwall as a diplomatic gift. Sikonan heritage made him a bit of an outsider in Dunwall, wink, but the capital city must have seemed exotic and full of old world mystery. A few months after he moved to Dunwall, it's recorded that Corvo received word that his mother had passed away several weeks after his departure from Karnaca.
Old Samuel made this. I'm glad he didn't live to see me driven out of Dunwall Tower.
Listen, I can and will read everything. There we're going. I really want to... I have this dream where someday we get...
The reserves won't help against Delilah. Even if I had a way to carry it all out of here.
Yeah, I have a dream where we get more.
I'll need this.
But that will. More Dishonored games set elsewhere in the Isles. I would love that. Right. I think we've dithered for enough time.
Ramsay deserves my attention.
I'm not gonna kill him. Ooh, I see. See, I was more than contented to just like leave him there to die in the bathtub with a slightly broken neck. But hey, that's just me, right? Drop him there next to the safes that he so loved, and I'll eat all the fruit.
Now you've got what you wanted, Ramsay. The Imperial suite atop Dunwall Tower. Stay put until this is all set straight, Ramsay. Enjoy the rations and well water, sleeping next to a fortune.
Let's get out of here. I'm so salty that I lost that ring. Delilah and Duke Luca Abele have taken the tower. Dunwall is no longer a safe place for you. Escape the city by meeting with the boat captain down at the docks. Gonna meet the bay, my one true love in video James. Where go do and know how drop assassinations work.
Until I understand this,
and I don't intend
to go into hiding.
To do it in this game.
I should make my way to the docks.
You got it. Thanks for the money, dickwads. For over a century, Double Town has been the capital of the Isle of Crystal and seat of power across all the isles of the Empire. Rulers have come and gone, each adding something to the structure. Gardens, observatories, new walls and pools, specialised interior chambers to suit their needs and whims. Double Tower has withstood numerous wars, several large-scale fires, and the collapse and rebuilding of the Northern Wing. With Tivian Sokonos joining the Empire first, it was Morley that resisted the longest. Some of the conflicts that arise also necessitate the further fortification of the tower. Repeated assassination attempts near the end of the conflict with Morley resulted in the creation of the Royal Protector position, with each ruler choosing their own Royal Protector after careful consideration. Perhaps in retrospect, other historians will see how easy it was for us to fall into the trap set by the schemes who managed the assassination of Empress Jessamine Caldwin. By allowing them to write history, it was for years thought that her trusted protector, Corvotana, was also her murderer, a concept we now know to be utterly false. Yet even after the tricksters themselves were put down, banished or imprisoned, it remained common knowledge that the royal protector was also Jessamine's murderer. How nicely they arranged histories for us, and how readily we devoured their stories, hungry for each perfectly cooked morsel. But it is well past time for us to set aside this plate of lies. The schemers were not to be trusted with the Empire, or with Jessamine's life, and they are certainly not to be trusted with the writing down of history. Fucking A, dude. Fucking A. Right. What?
We gotta get out of Dunwall.
Yep, we sure do.
Delilah turned my father to stone. I will find a way to undo it.
Evil magic, that's how she did it. Although not really evil, it's the outsider whom... I need the one that gives me faster strangulation.
Traitorous dog.
Yep. We'll leave him there. Munch, I'm gonna eat his bread too while we're at it. That's my true revenge, just eating everything I can find.
Duke's men. I need to find a ship.
Ramsay's missing. Corporal Moore checked the royal quarters, and Emily Caldwin has apparently fled the tower. We've got to find her. That's it. You've got your orders. Spread out and find the fugitive. We're in this with the Duke of Sirkonos, sink or swim. There's no way to turn back now.
Want you two in place, just after the Duke and her new Empress make their appearance. Things will happen fast. Do your part in this to share the spoils for you and the others. Turn on me now and ask the Duke to send his assassins after your dear old parents. Trust me, the so-called Crown Killer is the last dinner guest you want in your home. Okay. Dude, can I take you out? No, that guy is gonna cause me a headache. F6. F9. I can and will save Scum in order to go as low chaos as possible.
Stuck in the leg, that's what. Worse than nothing.
former Empress Emily Caldwin has been accused of high crimes against the state. Anyone caught harboring her is equally guilty of treason.
Ooh, nice.
Getting so one can't even breathe no more.
You in here? Nope. Dope. Fangs. Is there a reason to come in here? Lovely. I've lived in Dunwall most of my life, surviving even the dreaded rat plague 15 years ago. I remember people fighting and killing each other with a half-empty elixir flask. I dealt with housebreakers repeatedly back then, and ultimately decided to sell my house at Clavering in favour of a more secure location. Surely I won't be disturbed anymore, living so close to Dunwall Tower itself. On some days, I've even seen the Empress riding by in a carriage. Once already, I thought I spied the Royal Protector on a nearby rooftop, watching a street altercation blow. So I feel safer now. I have less space here, but should be able to construct my experiments without fearing the loss of any expensive lab equipment or the funding might work, so... Right, just something depends on. Gross, gross, gross. Starting a new year, maybe 1850 will be less boring than 1851. Can't wait for one to get back to Dunwall. We'll go to the abandoned mansion I discovered the other night at the edge of Rodshaw. Maybe we'll have time to turn into a scary haunted house beforehand, using sheets and hiding an old autograph upstairs. Wyman would love that. We'll get spooked and hold hands, screaming and laughing. Come on, Emily, you promised to be more serious and listen at court, and you're already planning your next escape. Let's start this diary again. Proposals for new decree on well-oiled rationing and distribution. That time of year again, anniversary of Mother's death. There's no real time for reflection, though. It's all security protocols, menus, guest lists, and it's impossible to slip out at night. I feel like a caged bird. They've already got me memorizing this year's speech. It's endless. Would it be so terrible if I just said what I remember about her? That wink she gave me even as she was scolding me after I was caught climbing the statue of Grandfather. Sound of her footsteps as she paced at night. The time she had a cap on the boat to Driscoll. One time she agreed to let Corvo teach me to fish, but then had to pull a hook from my arm. Now that would be a speech. Honestly, sounds a lot like my dad, minus the hooks and shit, but... Right. Clue to this safe. Should be somewhere around here. 451. What a terrible place to put that. You'd have to take the painting down every time you forgot. If you steal from this guy a couple of times, you get an achievement. I think that's the main reason to come in here. With that obsession with fish bits.
Something's... It's not my job to clean up.
Just keep sneaking. Go in here. Can't see anyone, so I'm going to say yes. Nothing up here but more fruit. That's okay, I will eat it all and I will take the money too. Ooh.
Air feels heavy. Hard to get a good lung full.
Okay, can that guy please? Nope. Nope, don't worry about it. go. Nice. Nothing in here to nick. It's all I care about is things to steal and eating lots of fruit. TFN. Worth. Right. Whoops. Let's get out of here, I guess. Gonna notice me, or am I out of its line of sight? I would really like to take that. It seems dangerous, but that's never stopped me in the past, and it won't stop me now.
Former Empress Emily Caldwin is now wanted for treason. Any of you found harboring Emily Caldwin will be fined and arrested.
People of Dunwall, stay in your homes. You're advised to stay indoors during this time of unrest.
What's going on in here? Fancy house. Going to go in it. Oh, shit. Okay. Where are you off to, dude? I appear to be dropping some frames again. I do apologize. I hate that we get the sound of footsteps. I know it's the sound of our footsteps, but it really freaks me out because I keep going, there's somebody walking up behind me. And I know there's not. I know it's just me, but... anything around here? Probably nothing. But you never know. Ooh, a statue. A globe. Well, here's what I know. Corvo is currently the fuck's humming? It's terrifying. Corvo is currently a statue, and I am sneaking through a fancy house, taking much longer than I need to get out the city, but it's okay. Because it's my game and I can play it how I want to. Plus, I want to investigate the fancy house.
In addition, Empress Delilah Caldwin, rightful heir to the throne, has taken power in Dunwall. The usurper, Emily Aton.
Huh? What? I don't want to die.
Don't worry about it. I'm not going to kill you.
Traitorous dog.
That man, part of the Duke's coup, I'm sure of it now. And I saw him talking to Captain Ramsay of the City Watch.
You weren't the only one fooled. But I never ordered those killings.
I know that. It was irresponsible of me to print the name Crown Killer.
Thanks for admitting it, dude.
I allowed myself to be coerced. Forgive me.
You're forgiven. I'm not sure what happens next, but protect yourself. And when the time is right, tell people the truth.
You can count on it. I won't ask you what your plans are, but for the sake of Dunwall and for the Empire itself, I hope you succeed.
Thanks, dude. Ooh, nice, I just got an achievement. Save the printer of Dunwall. Neat. Don't take it personally, I'm not publishing a story about mechanical soldier Dan Kanaka. I'm not questioning your sources or your writing. Some moonstruck natural philosopher making marionettes in his basement isn't really news. Done some research on this Kieran Jirendarshi mentioned, who's driven out the Academy of Natural Philosophy years ago, so he's hardly a credible threat. Until one of his inventions actually kills someone, it's not worthy of our ink. Should really focus on the Crown Killer case instead. If the Imperial family is really ordering those orders, I want us to be the ones to expose it. Oh, don't worry, it will kill someone. Me, over and over again. Right. I wonder if I can sneak over into there. I bet I could, you know. Ow. And just because I shouldn't, won't stop me.
Road is blocked by order of the City Watch.
Locked? What am I supposed to do now?
Concerned citizen, I'd advise you to return to your home.
That's it for me.
Oh, this is a terrible assignment. Who wants to keep one?
Huh? Where did you go?
That's Emily Caldwell.
Piss.
Oh, mercy! You aren't going anywhere!
Ow. You stop that. Ah. Oh.
Finish her!
Sorry, I'm dropping frames again. I think it's my net. When did I last save? Too long ago, that's when. Right.
Road is blocked by order of the City Watch.
Locked? What am I supposed to do now?
Not my concern, citizen. I'd advise you.
Gotta get away. I should talk to the captain of that ship.
Hi.
Maybe I should hire my own buck. First the shortage of whale oil, then the murders. Now,
no,
what's ever going on tonight?
I can't do anything for you. You'd better run.
Fuck off.
You have to understand.
I mean, I
I'm
do,
going
but...
to call for help if you don't go. Elaine heard fighting between some of the guards earlier. This is bad.
Hi.
You have to understand. I'm going to call for help.
I pay my taxes and all the fees. I'd pay bribes too if it meant the roads weren't blocked off.
You up for a beer later?
You bet.
That's Emily Caldwell.
No, no, no.
What's going on?
Ah, shit. I may have made a mistake. It's okay. I do it all the time.
I'm going to call for help if you don't know.
Sick. Okay, dude, do what you want. Okay, I'm going. Look. Look at all the out of here that I'm currently getting. Path around there. I can pop in here. Nope. What happened? Don't worry about it.
Duke didn't hire the most refined assassin.
Oh, piss. What? You didn't see anyone, dude. Don't worry about it. Someone didn't steal everything, just most things. Why did someone put bullets in a safe?
So it's a coup. Caldwin's have finally fallen. Never thought I'd see the day.
It seems so. And even the legendary Corvo Atano couldn't stop it.
Don't talk about my dad that way. Even see where you are, my good bitch. Don't tell me my business. Fans been at this game for a long time, I'm not acting alone. Currently have several friends working on similar pamphlets aimed at further turning public opinion against Emily Colton, a cursed royal protector. Lady Bramley is calling her bastard daughter. That ought to lighten them up at court. Nathan Bettenbridge is nearly finished with prosecution for Corvo Atano. I'm giving consideration to releasing my owners. Should Parliament rule? A modest proposal. Yes, I know she's the Empress, but eventually she'll bow under the weight it will bring down upon her. First the gentry here in Dunwall, then the Parliament, finally the other Earls. Early next month, look for these works plastered on the walls here in the capital city. But if you're abroad, you'll see them in Dubrovka, Alba, Karnaca, Kilkenny, and Yarrow as well. I have friends all over, Laura. Don't let it slip your mind for a second. Ah, so he's the... That's why he's dead. Because he's a dick. Right.
Come out wherever you are.
are you, my good bitch? You downstairs?
Where are you hiding?
Where are you hiding? Why is there blood everywhere? Gross. Lots of things that make noise. Nothing that's actually helpful. Right. Ah, shit. Nope, don't worry about it. On the 16th day, month of Earth, before midnight, I was on my way home after a couple of hours at the pub, stopping to pee next to the Boyle Company offices. I heard moaning and furniture creaking. I thought so maybe some people having fun, I could have a peek. When I got close to the windows, that was when Mr. Boyle started screaming like a slaughtered pig. He was all tied up. There was someone wearing a hooded cloak, and I swear, I think he was eating up Mr. Boyle's guts. Has to be the Crown Killer, I told myself, and so I ran as fast as I could to the nearest watch post to get help. Your soldiers could have made it to the Boyle in time if they hadn't taken half an hour to find me for throwing up. Anyone would have done the same after what I'd been through. You guys should have some respect. Knowing as I do who the Crown Killer actually is, that's really interesting. Right. It's Ollie, the fuck out of here, lads. Nope, don't worry about it. You think you can see me, but you can't.
I'll search with you.
See if she can help. See, what I'm going to do is get out of here this way. Nothing, don't worry about it.
You have to understand. I'm going
the Hatter Gang. Also ready to profit from times of turmoil.
Will they yell at me if probably. I'm gonna take them out just in case. You never know. I do want to see what's over here, though. I've left, dude. Chill. Don't worry about it. They'll survive. Nope. I've left. Fuck me. Emily Caldwin, want us through Dunwall, strangling everyone she sees, just in case. An official quote from Emily. You never know, right? Oh, they're only little rats, it's fine. Nope. Don't worry about it. Just need to get up there, so let's swim for it.
Came here to lady.
Hi.
You want to hear what I've got to say? I guarantee it.
Probably do.
Lady Emily, you won't get far with that face. Stamped on half the coins in the city.
There's a coup underway and I'm being blamed for the Crown Killer murders. I don't care what my face looks like.
My name's Megan Foster.
Sure it is, babe.
I work with an old ally of yours, Anton Sokolov. We learned something scary down in the south. And I came to warn you.
I know, Anton. But Corvo's gone. The Duke of Cirkonos is here with a woman named Delilah. They massacred everyone in the throne room. Then she did something I can't explain. There was nothing to do but run.
Sometimes that's all you can do. This is my ship, the Dreadful Whale. We can head out as soon as you're ready.
I need to get to Karnaca where the Crown Killer murders started. Delilah must have been down there for a while, and I've got to figure out what's going on.
You're Corvo's daughter. I'll give you that. Should we go?
Let's get out of here.
I'm ready.
It's contempt. Sorry, I'm picking up the looking up the achievement for robbing Galvani multiple times. Okay. Contents of the safe in to the Empress. Right. I need to go back in there and nine. Nice. Dope. Something feels off. Find out what's going on. I really am sorry that I'm dropping so many frames. I'm not sure if Twitch is having issues or if possibly Virgin is still recovering from their issues the other day.
Am I still aboard Megan's ship? Feels odd.
Sure does, don't it, mate? F5J. Okay.
What is this place? Where am I?
You must have dreamt before.
Moving closer, watching.
Hiya.
Empress Emily.
Hey, help me, duck.
I am a friend of your father's from the bad old days.
What a good quote, eh?
I never expected us to meet. I watched your mother die at the hands of schemers who wanted your little empire. Then you were rescued by a man in a strange mask. I thought that was the end of the excitement. But someone yanked the rug from under your feet. You've lost your throne and your father. And I promise, Delilah won't just give them back. So, what are you prepared to do about it? Your Imperial Majesty? And are you clever enough to do it without spilling a river of blood?
Boy, howdy, do I hope so.
I asked Corvo those questions 15 years ago. This is the moment that changed him. Now it's your turn.
Absolutely.
Burns. From the inside. I feel like I'm standing at the edge of something. Stories. They're true.
Yep, they sure are. No, I'm gonna keep that at one, actually.
Incredible. This is how I'm going to save my father and reclaim the throne.
Yeah, it is, babe. Beautiful. You love to see it.
Corvo mentioned being here once.
Hi, Mum.
I know you. Do you remember? It's been so long, and you've been through so much. Even as an echo of myself. It's good to know you're there.
Mother? You're here, but you're not here. In my hand, but
somewhere else.
Yep.
Only the last of my essence with you for a while. If only I could reach across this great expanse and take you into my arms. But I have this to offer. My gift and my curse. Summon me to your hand, and I will guide you when I can.
I have such odd affection for the fact that we are basically, you know, running around with our dead mother in our hand now. So pretty, though.
Who is Delilah, really? How could she? I don't understand.
Few have seen this place. Three empresses.
I wonder who the third was.
There's no one quite like Delilah. I watched her pull herself up from blood and filth. Until she was in a position to steal from the wisest scholars in the Empire. Survival and ambition, art and magic, with a cunning that makes fawning sycophants of those around her, all of it leading to what you saw at Dunwall Tower. Delilah's playing the long game. She took all the abuse the world could deal out, and now she has a crown. But I'll let you in on a secret. She's got her eyes set on a much greater prize.
I do find Delilah such a fascinating character. Meet with Megan Foster and discuss a plan of action before taking this gift to Karnaca. I have this fascination with Delilah. I've drawn straight into her schemes, no doubt, but...
When I was 10 years old, bored with my lessons, I dreamed about sword fighting and sailing the ocean. Now I'm realizing that the world is stranger than I ever imagined. Everything I know has been turned on its head, but I'm dealing with it the best I can. When you look at the great jeweled map at Dunwall Tower, Karnaca is the southernmost port in the Empire. A fat, red ruby. That's how I always thought of it. Up close, the city smells like the ocean and strange spices.
Upstairs says Thump.
Close. It's a tangled story of blood and ambition.
Aren't they all?
The birthplace of my father. Megan Foster is a stranger, but there's something that makes me want to trust her.
It's the fact that she's the absolute babe.
Dunwall, and I need answers. Delilah and the Duke made me look like a murderer. Using the crown killer to butcher my political adversaries. They took what was mine, and I'm gonna get it back.
Here we go. Well, it was pure luck, but I managed to get myself past this Tremorley above decent ship. Dreadful Whale, it's called. Is that a mistake? Shouldn't it be the Dreadful Whale, like the sea beast? I don't want to risk pointing something out to that captain, that Foster lady. She looks like the sort to dump a scroll passenger overboard without a second thought. Goodbye, Karnaca. I won't miss you. Times are getting bad there. I don't know what's more unbearable, breathing mind dust all day long or hearing constant rumblings of Duke Luca Bele over the speakers. Every bar I'd have played and some drag asked me to sing a song, either making the Duke sound like a hero of the people or the opposite, the West Berlin generation. Got sick of it pretty fast. Take a few weeks to get to Morley, give or take some days, depending on the currents and winds. Appreciate the company of Captain Foster and the other passenger, a Tivian scholar. Try to help out around the boat as much as I can, cooking, cleaning, repairing stuff, playing the guitar for them at night. I hope they don't throw me to the sharks when they find out I'm dirt broke. We won't be able to pay my fare when we reach Morley. Morning food seems to suit Captain Foster. She likes the way I use lots of sugar and toss a shot of whiskey into all my recipes, even if she's grassed at the end of the week for how many of the supplies I've gone through. Spent the night on deck with Megan and Anton, though he slept in a chair nearby, wrapped in a goat hair blanket that looks like it hasn't been washed since it was on the goat's back. Played the guitar while Megan and I drank rum and whiskey, singing sad old Sakonan ballads and giving silly names to the stars. She even hummed along with me when she got drunk enough, but I mostly prefer just to listen. Said I have this same voice as someone she knew once a long while back. Off and on I hear her playing the same old audio graphic in the cabin, making me wonder if that's who she's talking about. Maybe I'm feeling jealous. What a fool I am, trying to kiss Megan down in the engine room. She didn't even yell, just smiled a sad smile, like you would at a child who still believes in night spirits. Tomorrow I'll reach Morley, and I'll disappear as quietly as I can. Decided to leave her my Sakonan guitar as a souvenir, and the only payment I can afford. I hope she'll forgive me, and that she'll find whoever she's looking for. I love that. Bolt. My father is lost, turned to stone by Delilah. These words I don't even seem real. Witchcraft, something I never would have believed possible. But now I have to believe in it, so I can believe that it can be undone. Delilah claims to be my aunt, the rightful heir. Truth or lies, all I know is that she used magic to take my throne, aided by that weasel, Duke Abele. They must have been working on the plan for years, buying disloyalty with promises. Even Ramsay, captain of the City Watch, planting in everyone's mind the idea that my father and I would be responsible for those monstrous killings, that one or both of us were the Crown Killer. I'm not in a trusting mood, but Megan Foster says she knows Anton Sokolov, our old royal physician, and she helped me escape the coup, so she's all I have right now. We're sailing for Sakonos. My Dunwall, my home, is no longer safe for me, but I never really was safe. I never really will be. The sooner I get that through my skull, the better. This time it wasn't a dream. I've read about the world in The Outsider. Imagine them. Now I've seen these wonders myself. Strange doesn't begin to cover it. The Outsider's terrible eyes, black on black. He offered me something. I know these gifts come with a price, but how could I refuse? This power might give me the edge I need to defeat Delilah and Duke Abele. I'll worry about paying the cost later. And what price will I pay for his other's gift? My mother's beloved voice, trapped in the strangest contraption. It is both comforting and chilling to be able to talk to her again, and yet it's not entirely the person I knew anymore. This thing, the heart, is there and not there. I have to focus in a new way to even see it. We've arrived at the southernmost tip of Kanaka. Strange fragrances all around. Salt, fish, spice. I don't even know how to blend in here. I don't know what to eat or where to go, but this is where my father was born, so part of me belongs here too. And these are my people, or they were until my stone was stolen by Delilah. I'm coming for you, Delilah, with my new powers. All I need now is a plan. Oh my god. It's fine. I've got two dark vision. That's what I want. After that. There we go. Shadow Walk should probably be my next one. Four rings. I don't really want that, but I do want Vitality, Agility. Domino could be really helpful. Here's me. Okay, I gotta fix these. I want you to be one, I want you to be two, I want you to be three, I'm gonna put you as seven. There we go. That's it, right. I know what you're used to living in a palace, but this is all the corn I could scrape up. Anton and I operate on a tight budget. Guess what? Now you do too. If it's not beneath you, pick up whatever valuables you find along your way. I want your damn own resources to take down the people behind the cave. Hidden all over the city, there are underground black market shops. Look for a symbol depicting two hands, which means there's a shop nearby. Follow the signs, they'll guide you. Buying from the black marks against the law, but it can make the difference against Duke's military. Sokolov was working on this crossbow's gift for you. If you need it modified, the shops can help with that as well. Dope. Gonna get my sleep darts. And I will be a happy bunny. Pair the thing that got busted on Anton's room when he was taken. It's been weeks now. Scratch that. Not until I bring him home. As a show of faith that he will be coming back. Unblock the storage door. Looks like something fell on the other side. I really need to sell the stuff locked up in there to make some coin. Pay the port tax and look the other way for you so those Grand Guard bastards before they wonder who my passenger is this time. I'll do it when I get the money. Anton, your idea of improving your head gasket sealing with the guano coating was the worst idea you ever had. I'll make you sleep in the engine room if you don't fix your mist by tomorrow. If all inventors were delicate and short-tempered as you are, you and I would still be paddling around in carved out logs. I made some mulberry cake. It's my own recipe improved by Tivian spices. I left it in the gallery. Anton, where are you, old fool? I hope nobody hurt you. I'll find you, I swear. I miss you. Rats. I can smell smoke again, but I'm pretty certain. Emphasis on the pretty certain. That. Just pick it up, just to see, you know? Right. Let's pick this up first before we do anything else. Fine, chill. Right. Let's go talk to Megan.
You're up.
Hi.
When you're ready to talk, I'll tell you what I know.
Sure, I just want to like look at everything first, if that's okay. As is my want. On the position of the effects of the winds of Kanakulang mass and resulting economic positions. Whale oil, liquid power. How astonishing that within these beasts inside the oil harvested alongside their flesh. It was enough power to see the isles through these tumultuous years. And it all seemed limitless, but now the lights begin to dim. Our fisher folk say the great beasts are increasingly rare. Not all places will suffer this loss equally. Follow natural philosophers. Karnaka has a unique feature, the cleft in Shindere Peak, through which the winds are channeled and amplified. His whale oil begins to run short, with the cost of finding the remaining leviathans escalating beyond the worth of oil itself. Karnaka will find itself and ascend it amongst the isles. That's right, lads, natural.
We've been en route for 2 weeks. I hope Sokolov is alright, wherever he is.
Awesome, please forgive my need to look after everything. Adithia Abele, steward of Calero. With sword in hand, she swept the Marshal Braida, sacrificing life for Konos. It will provide newly uncovered insights into the exploits of Rubinos Abele, who built the ornate wooden bridges of Sargento. Follow along as we map out the expansions occurring under the Abeles, through which trade routes to the other isles were established, bringing riches to the nation-state. Even as waves of settlers continued to join Sokonos from Morley, the Abeles balanced growth against Konan culture. In later chapters, we will detail the times of Theodonos Abele, true son of Sokonos. Brave and benevolent, he united the East and West as no other but not for him. Even the rowdy peoples of Bastilion swore loyalty to him. One hour, one Sokonos, united under House Abele. Lastly, we will settle on Luca Abele, who rules today, partaking in feasts and merriments of all kinds, bringing joy to our fair isle. Feasts and merriments, eh?
It looks like the overland route to the Attermeyer Institute goes through the carriage station.
Karnaka looms from a distance.
The Duke couldn't have pulled off the coup without someone inside the City Watch. I don't know Duke Luca Abel, but Corvo served under Luca's father and said Theodanus was a good man. Delilah. My aunt, if that's really true. She has a twisted way of looking at the world.
Most gruesome way, her suspects still at large. A stranger defeated spotted the crime scene. Public is urged to be watched for annual suspicious figures.
So the crown killer was a tool of the Duke's...
Even the stranger in the pub could be our suspect.
The murders had a calculated effect. Sokolov seems so much older now.
I mean, he really is. Created by Dr. Alexandra Hypatia, alchemist of renown, Adamire Institute of Infectious Disease, derived from rare and exotic ingredients, including blood fly venom itself.
Why is this here? It's Delilah.
Anton started it just before he was taken.
Because she's an absolute babe, that's why.
He wouldn't say more.
I'll always miss my lessons with Anton Sokolov.
Why can't an old man enjoy his last years in a warmer climate with good wines and spicy foods without stumbling into another nest of aristocratic vipers, eager to crawl around the heart of the Empire? As I've learned more each week for months now, I find my mind turning over the movements beneath the surface here in Karnaca. Duke Luca Abele, I'm going to keep pronouncing it that way, and some in a circle that seems to even include Captain Mortimer Ramsay of Dunwall City Watch, a betrayal that boggles the mind. How many others are involved? They aimed their venom at our dear Empress, young Emily, that much is certain, but when will they strike and how? Do I dare spend another month gathering stray bits of esoteric information, linking it together with what we already know? Can we even afford another week, or should Megan and I set out for Gristle tonight, taking this leaky tub up through the canal? Corvo will not hesitate. He will act as soon as I hand over what I know, and if I'm too hasty, it might be his undoing, coming home to his native Sakonos without some critical piece of knowledge about this affair. And then there's a crown killer to worry about. If that fiend is part of Duke Luca's, Duke Abello's schemes, as I suspect, how long until the dreadful whale catches the Duke's eye?
I made so many clever devices during my mother's time.
Mm-hmm.
When I left Gristle years ago, I swore I'd never again take part in any further political matter. I've done my share of bad things, and some good, before and after the Red Plague. But here in Karnaca, I've uncovered a terrible conspiracy against you. Here, at the bottom of the Empire, the cobblestones smell of death and corruption. Staying with an associate, Megan Foster, aboard her vessel, the Dreadful Whale. We'll leave for Dunwall in the morning, as soon as the tides are willing. I keep thinking of the way sweet Jessamine was stolen from you and your father, and I fear it might be your turn to face such turmoil. I know Corvo would protect you with his life, but please do not trust anyone.
There you are, old man.
We hates it, Precious. We hates it. Wonder whether I have another book in me. Bloodfly epidemic coupled with basic information on life cycle and behaviour might make an excellent project for this old natural philosopher. Bloodflies are exotic insects, unlike anything else found in Sakonos. I suspect they originated on the Patisian continent. In groups of three or fewer, they're harmless. Individuals won't attack, leading me to speculate that each emits a scent that has a collective effect on a larger number of bloodflies. Bloodflies are attracted to rapid movement and sound. The nest can be broken apart, scattering the swarm, and in particular, the nests are quite susceptible to fire. Insects require fresh corpses to lay their eggs, which hatch in breathtaking fashion after a very short time. More corpses in Sakonos City, say, during a crisis or plague, means more bloodflies. Interestingly, in the last part of the bloodfly's life cycle, they calm a great deal. Leaving the swarm they molt, causing the wings to drop off, after which each bloodfly leaves a solitary existence. Very odd. Bloodflies are largely restricted to the south, preferring warmer climates, like certain aging natural philosophers. Horrible is what they are. A colleague of mine owns a stunning map of the known world, adorned with curlicues and sea beasts, has a cherished spot over her mantle. She paid handsomely for it and was so bristled when I enumerated the various errors. Chief amongst them, of course, a size and placement at the Pandasian continent. Oh, how cartographers are loath to show how small and distant our empire really is compared to that giant landmass. It's a fantasy world a few days' journey from Aran. Every veteran ship captain knows it takes months to reach these shores. I no doubt that Pandizia was rich in resources, but a place must be understood if we ever hope to exploit its myriad treasures. Those were my thoughts as I agreed to join the ill-fated expedition, and so it was on the third day of the month of Earth, under calm and gray skies, the great seal vessel Antonio Aquilo set sail with captain, crew, researchers, and myself, 38 of us total, for what would be the most terrifying and spiritually draining experience of my life. Okay, I'm done chatting. Oh, I'm done looking at everything.
All right, you've explained part of it. But what were you and Sokolov doing here?
The old man loved Karnaka, but he'd caught wind of a conspiracy tied to the Crown Killer. He wanted to warn Corvo.
There are reports about tensions rising, corruption, street violence. I didn't give it much mind. Usually the local authorities resolve that sort of thing.
The new Duke has let things slide, but Sokolov concluded he might be the head of the conspiracy. He came in looking shocked, and if you've heard his after-dinner stories, you know that's unusual. We were going to set out for Dunwall, but something happened.
The Crown Killer.
Yes, the hatch ripped open and Sokolov screamed. All I caught was a glimpse of someone carrying him across the deck. I followed as long as I could, toward Attermeyer Institute. It's run by the alchemist Hypatia. Maybe the Duke is using a patient of hers, the Crown Killer.
Attermeyer. All right, I'll get inside. The Crown Killer has to be eliminated, and if the alchemist will cooperate, maybe I can learn something about what happened to Sokolov. Wish me luck.
If you need my luck, Sokolov's as good as dead.
Thanks.
When you get done at the Institute, disable the watchtower. Once it's down, I'll bring the boat around. We'll take the skiff to the shore when you're ready.
Okay, we've read that one.
This Dr. Hypatia.
She sure does, hey?
The good that's possible within the Empire.
Doesn't she just? Right, before we hop in the skiff, hop out the whip, hop in the skiff.
There are a few black market shops scattered across the city. Brisk trades in bullets and knives these days.
There is a thing that I'm going to do first. Hop in here. Here we go. There's some of that. And also some of those. Adorna set out with a group that foraged east and included two other natural philosophers and four crewmen. We used blaze to clear away the vegetation that grew thickly here and slowly made our way away from the shore up a steep incline. Our purpose was to gather samples of native plants for our research journals. I found myself pressing leaves and stems between pages and taking copious notes on several species of flora I surmised no human had ever set eyes on previously, when suddenly young Mr. Gravett from the Academy began hopping and screaming loudly. Chance had bade him to pick an unfortunate place to step. Aggressive ant-like creatures swarmed him from below. So many in number were his tiny attackers that we quickly lost sight of him under the bronze door. We finally managed to pull Gravett from the insects, acquiring several painful belts where we come to his aid. Miss Gravett, however, was bitten, or stung as I'd eventually discover, so many times he was barely recognisable. Swollen under deformity over every inch of his person, moaning like a sick bull, he expired before we could carry him back to the beach. Luckily, some of the creatures still clung to him, providing me with precious samples. Not creepy in the slightest. Whoops, wrong one. There we go. Right. Now. Let's get out of here.
Ready for me to drop you at the docks?
Let's go.
Go see the streets where my father grew up.
Off we go then.
It won't do to be recognized.
Find Adamire Station and take a carriage to Adamire Institute. It is the best lead you have for tracking down the Crown Killer. Cassianus will perform while threatened. Track and track and I'll attack strangers on site. This should sort of obstacles or problems. So if someone attacks them in the street, they'll help them fight back. Special blood flies. So you can spend money to upgrade. Class may skill on the streets, even if your weapons are drawn. Shut it down using the lever. I think my internet's wind powered as well, am I right, lads?
I'd take you to Ademeyer by boat, but security's too tight. The grand
don't worry about
it. Watchtower there. Go inland and use the carriage station.
Will do.
Before his death, the old Duke of Sirkono spent decades building up Karnaca. After Duke Luca Abel took over, he started draining the wealth out of the city as fast as he could. Orgies and week-long feasts.
Sounds like a man to party with.
Here than we were in Dunwall, it seems. Watch yourself on the way to Ademeyer. The Duke's given the Grand Guard run of the city. Strangers get attacked on sight. I'll keep my head down. This is a good spot. Reach Ademeyer, take out the Crown Killer, and find out where Sokolov was taken. The alchemist, Hypatia. She'll help if she can. Sokolov likes her.
I like her too.
I'll see you later at Ademeyer.
So fun fact.
The boat until after I've disabled the watchtower.
When I did my lethal playthrough of this, okay. The Orcaville. Too many deaths will lead to high levels of blood from the station and darker final outcome. What I want to say, fun fact, when I did my non-lethal playthrough, my lethal playthrough of this, Hypatia was the only one where I refused to kill her. I love her a lot. But Captain Megan Foster, she helped me escape the coup, but she's given me the side eye when she thinks I'm not looking. She's all I've got for the moment, though soon I hope Anton Sokolov will be joining us. My old teacher, keenest intellect in the Empire, filthy mouth, gone and girl, himself abducted. Megan says he was last seen being dragged towards Ademeyer Institute by the Crown Killer, which makes no sense to me unless the killer is a patient there. Maybe he needs medicine or something, but how can a deranged patient be working for the Duke and Delilah? Ademeyer's chief alchemist might know, Alexandria Hypatia. She's been running this place for years. She's famous for curing the miners' diseases. If she knows anything, I'll make her talk. F5, here we go, right.
That's Ademeyer in the distance. Right then. Maybe a little more.
Okay. Right, what have we got? 141 meters, 146, 175. 19 and 66.
Are you coming tonight?
That's the one I'm after.
Not this time.
Where am I gonna find the money for that? You still eat meat? All the blood flies are all. I'm not sure it's safe.
Sorry before, I get what you're saying about tangling with the Howlers, but they don't run the black market here, really. They just take a cut from all the shops. Yeah, the Grand Guard will crack our heads or shake us down if we get caught, but they'll do that no matter what we do. We're new here, and we picked a bad time to move to Karnaca. We've got to do whatever we can to stay afloat, even if it means dealing with black markets. So I'm going to find the shop in each district across this rotting corpse of a city, and I'm going to get to know the shopkeepers. Butter them up. You're still my love, my apple, even when I yell at you, even when I curse and throw things. I'll let you make it up to me when I get home tonight. Okay, all the flights there. I see your officers there and Adam, my station is there. Am I right or am I right? Blood everywhere.
Hello there.
No longer any doubt that the recently unseated Empress, Emily Colden, is responsible for the recent string of horrible murders. Former monarch is on the run, confirming our suspicions about her guilt and association with the Crown Killer. Indeed, some of you even suggest that Emily herself committed the appalling crimes, as it is well known she was raised by conspirators and murderers. Rude. The Grand Conan Guard has promised rewards for any information leading to an arrest, and once a fugitive will be shot on sight if spotted. Duke Cabello recently cited the former Empress will likely receive a fair trial if she turns herself in peacefully and forthwith.
That's all I'm gonna say.
You're not from here, am I right? Welcome to Karnaca, then.
Your face is covered. Are you worried someone might recognize you?
No, don't worry about it.
Sorry, every now and then one of those Grand Guard bastards pulls a stunt like that. It's getting worse. But I might be able to help you out.
We're listening.
And what's next? There's a stack of goods that no one's claimed in one of the holding warehouses. I happen to know that no one's gonna claim it ever, because it was dropped from a boat, loading up for freight port. It's good stuff. Spices and dried fish. Maybe worth more than what you lost.
That's a good deal, Maya.
Thank you, Ramis.
All right. Still not fair than just taking what was ours, but we appreciate what you're offering. If it's like you say, and we can find buyers, then it'll get us through the next month.
Good, good. Look, I wish I could have stopped him. Just meet me here again tomorrow.
I like those guys that have the, like, pipes strapped. Splash, splash.
I have the following announcement. New restrictions are now in place due to the political assassinations conducted in the name of the former Empress, Emily Caldwin.
Chill, dude.
And carried out by the former royal protector, Corvo Attano.
I'm gonna sneeze.
The Conan Guard is stopping and questioning all foreigners and new workers on the streets of Karnaca. Compliance is mandatory.
An underground market. Illegal trade means weapons and ammunition.
Hey. Oh, you're kind. Thank you. If you want to get past that wall of light, I've heard people sneaking through this blood fly infested apartment. Let's hope you never need help.
Thanks, dude.
Something that might interest you.
God, absolute
My
babe.
My name is Mindy Blanchard, and you look like someone who goes into places where you don't belong.
Oh, girls with tattoos, my one true weakness.
You scratch my ass, I'll scratch yours.
I'd rather not, thanks.
I need to get to Attermeyer Institute. Can you help me with that?
Yeah, I know how to do that. You go get a body for me, and I'll help you with your problem. Don't worry. He's already dead.
A body? That's odd. From where?
The overseers are holding him at their outpost. They think he was a kind of a witch. I want the body for reasons of my own.
Don't worry,
Sneak
I won't question.
Take it, then meet me in the old basement below the dentist office near there.
I'll think about it.
I will do it.
Come in. If you've found this place, I'll trade with you.
Hi. What have you got for me?
Glad we could do business. I'll take that deal. You won't regret it. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. If the Grand Guard comes in, I don't know you.
No, you're right, you don't. Not fussed about that. I would like to save up for some of these.
I shouldn't deal with strangers.
There you go. Right. Cool. Two runes. Oh, three runes, so I'm pretty close to being able to afford Shadow Walk, which will make life a lot easier. Right, come on, resume. There we go. Now, we're gonna be sneaky. Sneaky deaky. We're gonna try to. Motherfucker for all they are worth. Because that's just who I am. Ah, damn. Paid for shit I didn't need, didn't I, lads? Oh, how annoying. Tyrone, whose job assistant won't be me. If you want the job, you'll just have to go get the shopkeep for my former assistant, he said. Here's the address, he said. Sir, you forgot to add that the guy didn't quit but died somewhere in a building so infested with the blood flies that Grand Guard condemned it. How's anyone supposed to get that key back? A lot of things I do for the job, Mr. Weatherby, but suicide isn't one of them. I know you'll ask some poor other guy, more naive or more desperate than me, but let me tell me one thing. That is not fair. Stinging bolts, nice. Spring razor. Ouch. Additional traffic. Piece of shit. Okay. Crunch. Right. Let's get out of here, shall we? Okay. You can see it's there. Just need to work out how to get in there.
get too close to the nest.
Either brave or desperate to accept this job. We used to smoke flash bloodlights with full crews, but the infestation's bad now, and Duke cancelled the funding, so we get rid of the nest by hand. Here's what you need to know to stay alive. If you need to slip past a bloodfly swarm or nest, keep your distance, move slowly, or they'll attack. When the bloodflies are calm, you're fine. If they take flight and start glowing, it's trouble. If you get swarmed, you've got to run away or fight. Smash the bloodflies or burn them. Same for the nests. A bloodfly swarm will keep coming back until you destroy the nest for that swarm. That's all you need to know, you'll do fine. Another thing, if you find any blood around the nest, just keep it as a bonus. Make sure the Grand Guard doesn't see it, or they'll ask for some urban sanitation tax or whatever.
Inside had any money. We just know they're dead and the plate.
Huh? What?
Someone's been attacked.
It's infested, all right. Move slowly, stay away from the nests, and try to avoid getting filled with bloodfly venom and eggs.
Yep. Save a lot. Oops. Ah, wrong button. Don't worry about it. I just wanted to see what was around there. I'm leaving now. It is so disgusting. Sorry for stealing from you, but you seemed like you didn't need it anymore. Me. So I was talking about this with a friend the other day, and I solidly am of the belief that the bloodflies are more disgusting. I'm going to try and avoid staring at their nests in case anybody here is not a fan of that. I'm of the opinion that bloodflies are grosser and... Yeah, I personally think bloodflies are worse. Just because they just like fucking get everywhere, you know? What's my new one? Yes, please. 98, 65, 63, 58, 94. Let's go this way next. It's not the closest, but that's never stopped me before. Right. What a letdown. Okay. I was trying to get out of there. Yeah. Lovely. Wrong button. There was really no reason for me to waste that on Century Bullet, but oh well. I did, and that's the life that we live now. Anything around here? That may have been the wrong thing to do. There we go, that's the stuff. Anything here? Just some... Ooh, some money. I will take that. Yes, I will. And I will also... Whoops. Do this.
Everyone's looking for me. It might pay to be discreet.
Oh, it almost definitely will pay to be discreet. That's really not so much a might as will. Does.
Miserable rat. I told you what would happen if you reported me. I warned you.
Up you get. Come on, there we go.
Move along. Mm. We're conducting a search for heretical artifacts.
Guess what happens next?
Here? Listen, I only...
This area is restricted on the authority of the Abbey. No one is allowed inside.
If anyone asks, he just ran through.
Alright, I'm gonna F5.
We will burn a bright fire with our virtuous actions, so the others will not lose their way.
I'll take you out. What's around here? Nothing? I'm trying to work out how to get in there.
Hey, you! Come here!
Never mind. Look at that. Yes, I will play this game very slowly. Just be patient with me. I'm enjoying myself, and that's what matters, isn't it, really? I may have accidentally saved when I didn't intend to. Okay, good, I haven't. What? Right. Oh, I nearly flung myself off there. That would have been bad. Don't yell, you're fine. Right.
I'm tired of the sound of my own voice. It's like I'm talking to a stone wall for all they listen.
Up here we go. Just you. Okay. He's gonna yell at me. But I'll hop across now that I know where I'm going. I just wish I'd saved when I got to the... got that bone charm. Thanks game for reminding me to save my game often. That's really helpful, that is. Well, let me just drop some frames again. Okay, good. I did. Right. Oh, that's the other thing I wanted to check. That's the wrong one. Bone charms. There we go. No, I don't want that. Ah, fuck. Hit it too late. I wonder if rather than making that jump, I could go onto the glass house and then jump down that way. That's probably the more efficient way of doing it, to be honest. And sensible, no less. Off. Nothing, just stuff, you know, just like stuff. Right, that's better. Hold again. Now. Hey. Fuck. Wrong way. I should have sniped. Sneaked across. Could use a sleep dart, but I want to conserve those as much as possible. Also, I'm going to go to 11:15 today, my time, to make up for the fact that I started a bit late. I feel like with my first stream of these games, I can always just, like, basically keep going forever. There we go.
Root out the signs of corruption. Seek the scribblings and scratchings of heresy.
Last week we talked to what a state I was in. It was good of you to take me aside and lend your advice. We'll take it to heart and know you are correct. Yes, I will need to be purified through the ritual. Ah, what a road I have ahead of me. I know it well, for you may not know, but I enjoyed the ritual once before. But 3 years ago, though I was young and strong, it came within an inch of death. If I may impose upon you once again, would you be so kind as to not mention our conversation to anyone? I'll arrange for the ritual, of course, very soon. Though I confess, ever since our talk, I feel much better. No comparison to the agitated state in which you found me. Peace and clarity have returned to me. Whoops. Clearly they're not looking very hard.
Karnaca was a lovely city once. Before the Duke began choking the life out of the place. Before the Crown Killer started painting the walls red. Now you're...
Oops, wrong button. Ah, sorry.
Nudge. Or pull it back from the edge.
We'll see, won't we?
We've both seen cities go bad before. Vermin, blood, and betrayal. It's happening again. I hope you're ready.
Thanks. So do I. They're also really not looking very hard, if they didn't see that. Right. I'm just checking the achievements quickly, so bear with me. I just want to check if there's an achievement for getting all the paintings, then I will try and do it. Without being spotted. There is. Okay, I'm gonna try for Shadow, but we'll see. And I was right, there is. Ah, I can get it, I can get Shadow Walk. Yeah, boy! That's the shit. I'm gonna save up for agility next, I think. Right. I want to pop this onto 6. Pop this onto 5. No. Pop that onto 4. This onto 5. Pop that onto 6. Rest of I'll save the rest of those, but for now.
That's the life.
Okay.
I will ask again today if this is truly her chosen path. I can only hope the outsider hasn't gotten to her first.
Okay. There he is. That motherfucker. What a tool. What a lovely sight, eh? Sorry, got an email that I was checking. Oh, don't give in to the oppressors. Easy for me to say. Nothing. Okay. How do I get to that bone charm then? Wemst. Ah, on the floor, I didn't look like an idiot. So dumb. Oh well. That's better. Okay, and where are we off to next? Going on a bone chomp there. There next. pop out of here. Whoops.
Who's this?
No one, don't worry about it.
So let's see.
What happened there is that, like an idiot, I flung myself over the side of the platform that I was hoping to climb over. Like a fool. Right. Actually, a thought. Is it better for me to sneak back over this way if possible? Survey says not possible. Whoops. Seaweed. My one true enemy. Come on, up you get. Nope, don't do that. Come on. You can do it. Fuck. It's fine, I meant to do that. Absolutely meant to do that. Don't worry about it. Ow. Nice. Right. Pop. Time to be sneaky beaky. If pos. If not, I shall cry. That's an effective use of my time. Right, I'm gonna save. Okay. I'm gonna be like, what the hell's that? And I'm gonna be like, nothing, don't worry about it, it's fine. Come on, get up, up. There we go. A mistake.
Why, burglar?
I didn't mean to do that. Went too far. can't whistle very well. I can whistle better than I used to be able to, I suppose, so it's not all the end of the world, but... Hi.
Hello, hello. Welcome.
Thanks.
Excuse me, but please stay in the part of the shop open to the public. Keep to the customer parts of the shop, please.
Absolutely not.
What's going on here?
Help me! Someone! Anyone!
Nothing here. Let's have a look around. Hey, you! Come here!
Only money in here, so that's fine. We'll get out of there. I wish I could whistle. I wish I could carry a tune. It's my one dream. God, so many frames dropped. Why is this happening to me? Don't worry about it. So. No, that didn't work. Okay, we'll have to think of another way. I wonder if there's a way in from inside or below. I can do this. Right, next step, find a way in.
I can smell the stench of heresy. So close.
Gross.
I wonder who that was.
Don't worry about it. Ugh. Can't loop.
Am I being presumptuous? Hoping to cross paths with that monstrous assassin?
In. Aha! That's the shit that I like to see.
Sometimes I wonder if it wouldn't be better to craft the music boxes at each enclave. Here in the city, for instance.
Still no word.
Instead, they're made in a few locations, kept from us, and shipped out.
Strange.
It seems dangerous.
I must draw
far worse to have the knowledge of construct.
Esteemed Hervestia Kulan, I hope you're in good health and not too nostalgic for Wagon, which I'm told is striking this time of year. Forgive my stream of letters, but our problems at Sikonos are significant. Any insights you can offer would be welcome. Duke Abel is a travesty, openly disdainful for the Abbey, and yet I must maintain relations with them for the welfare of this nation. You've been called a unifier, something the Abbey greatly needed after the horrors of the Rat Plague, so your guidance would be of value. Under the Duke, the streets are overrun with cutthroats. Paolo and his gang grow bolder every day. Lastly, my recent correspondence with the Oraculus has been troubling. The responses have arrived after market delay, and the recent proclamations possess an unusual cadence.
Materials scattered across the aisles. The metals used to make the devices are unusually rare. The techniques that apply by anyone but the most faithful, resolute overseers. Border on heresy,
burn a bright fire without virtue.
Right.
The grief of the other will not lose their way. Accomplish if they took the music boxes and perverted them to their own ends.
Exactly, brother. Much better to protect such a powerful tool. Assemble them in secret and dispatch them across the Empire where they're needed in the fight against the supernatural.
I'm gonna try something.
What's going on?
Did you hear someone?
Fuck.
Brothers,
oh. That didn't work. Never mind. I guess I'll have to knock him out then. That's really annoying. I don't want to waste the steep dart. But I can't. He'll cause an issue no matter what as he sits there. I suppose the other thing I could do is...
If they took the music boxes and perverted them to their own ends.
Throw it.
Something exactly, brother. Much better to protect such a
that way, way, maybe.
That sounded like a blasphemous wanderer.
Are they going to run in here?
You don't stand a chance anyway!
A stream of untruth. The
Whoops.
Echoes of lies come back as the voice.
It makes me sick.
Oh shit. Okay, well that didn't work. I did not mean to throw it at him. I meant to throw it as it, that way as a distraction. Guess I'm just too good at aiming, huh? I really am trying to go low chaos. I'm not like if I don't completely get clean hands, it's not the end of the world, but I really would like clean hands, you know?
Took the music boxes and perverted them to their own ends.
Still no
exactly,
word.
Brother. Much better.
Whoops.
What's going on here?
That didn't work. I guess I do have to knock him out.
If they took the music boxes and perverted them to their own end.
I wonder if I can.
What's going on? One of us is down. Like
broken glass. Deep breath fight.
Never mind. That's not going to work. I'll use a sleep dart on him. I think that'd be the easiest option. And I might be able to use a stun mine on those two and take them out. Or just yeet myself past him.
Cultists might accomplish if they took the music boxes and perverted them to their own ends.
Exactly. Much better to protect such a powerful tool.
Huh?
Assemble them in secret and dispatch them across the Empire where they're needed.
That's better.
Fight against the supernatural.
Hi, Peach. I hope you're doing well. I hope you are having a good day. I am currently attempting eventually to steal a body, but I must bring these structures to be safe. Core principles reinforced by overseer across the aisles. From principles to all manner of rules, social codes and beliefs about the cosmos. Wandering gaze, lying tongue, restless hands, roving feet. Rampant anger, wanton flesh, errant mind. The behaviours must be rejected in order to keep one's heart free from benevolences and roads to the outsider. Hello! Oh, I'm glad to hear it. I hope you're doing well. We are currently playing through Dishonored 2. It is not my first time playing, I just haven't played it for about 2 years, so I'm taking a bit of time to get used to it. It's the very, very first episode. Thank you. I'm doing my best. I got groceries today, and after this I'm going to play Assassin's Creed until I fall asleep, so doing good. It's a very first episode of Dishonored. So far what's happened is we have been betrayed. I'm now wandering around Karnaca, and I'm going very, very slowly, really taking my time because of who I am as a person. Also, my net is being a bit choppy, so I do keep dropping the occasional frames, so I do apologize. Find the
Vice Overseer Liam Byrne.
Right, so the bone charm and ring that we wanted downstairs. Here we go. It's closed. Vice Overseer. Four is holding, five is closed, and six at the rooftop. And then the body that we want is up there.
Stream of untruth. The echoes of lies come back as the voice of the outsider.
Oh, jeez. Wow, that's is very late.
Some take comfort from the strictures.
Not us anymore, though, right? Restrict the wonder of the gaze that looks hither and yonder for some flashing thing that easily catches a man's fancy in one moment, but brings calamity in the next. For the eyes are never tired of seeing, nor are they quick to spot illusion. A man whose gaze is corrupted is like a warped mirror that has traded beauty for ugliness, and ugliness for beauty. Instead, fix your eyes into what is edifying and to what is pure, and then you'll be able to recognize the profane monument of the outsider. Restrict the lying. I'm not going to bother reading all these, it's a nightmare. Right. Here we go. I'll stand back up again. See what I can knit from around here. As the sort of person I am. Seven strictures, especially hunger, mind, and gaze. So, if we hop back around here, it is 5, 7, 1. 5. I have no compunction from stealing from the overseers because they are corrupted and extremely rude. Nice, right now. The bone charm downstairs to get to. We'll grab that. And then we'll grab the body. Don't worry, I've got the heart equipped. Okay. Where do I go?
That we unite against the spirits of the unknown that would drag us screaming into the... Huh?
Nope, don't worry about it. I can't remember how to take you out, so we're going to struggle for a bit. Okay. Don't worry about it. Another one? take raw whale bone too. Dope. Unfortunately, I'm not going to get ghost, but that's okay. I will try for clean hands, and we'll get ghost another time. Right, where are we off to next? Ooh, no. Oops.
This was once my world.
This one next. From the northernmost shores to here, Karnaca in the south. Yep, it sure was. That's how I feel. Just in case anyone was wondering. Thank you, Fath. Sorry, I got distracted by trying to get through that. Yeah, I'm really not sure. Either OBS is having issues, my internet is having issues, or Twitch is. I think it may probably be my internet because we were having issues during the week. Unfortunately, that means there's really not much I can do to fix it. Love to get nowhere near the amount that I pay for, right? Yeah, unfortunately, just have to suffer through it. Nowhere. He'll send someone else. Maybe Overseer Kazan. Until then, we stay where we are.
Well, the heretic's corpse attracts like flies, brother.
Anything for me to nick? No, but there is some food, which is always good. What? Was that me? This way. There we go. Knock you out. Do, do, do. I need stronger arms. Where did you find these artings? Artings, drawings. I made them. As I said, I'm an artist. Mostly newspaper advertisements. These don't look like advertisements. They look like heretic nonsense intended to make your neighbour sick or bring back a loved one. Nothing will dissuade you of these notions, I'm sure. So instead of wasting my breath, I'll give you some advice. Take a bath once in a while, Overseer, and invest in some scented soap, unless that's against one of the strictures. Apparently the accused suffered from a weakened heart, dying during the interrogation without finding anything further. His apartment on the canal should be searched for items or drawings of a profane nature. Rip that dude, I guess. Okay. You guys appreciated my mention of artings. Mario, meet me in a normal place tomorrow night. Be sure to bring the drawings we talked about.
That's it. The body Mindy sent me after.
Right. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Meant to do that. Right. Where are we going? Where am I dropping you off? Mindy's place over that way. Right. Let's get out of here, shall we? Just realised I pronounced that game's name as Amadeo. Okay. Take care. You too. Have a good day. Look after yourself. And get some rest when you can. I hope things go well. Okay, Mindy. Where are you? Over there.
Still no word from our sisters.
I have my sister.
Very strange indeed.
Talk to him.
I must draw strength from my
brother. Don't worry about it.
What's going on here?
What?
What's going on here?
My mistakes. What? It's fine. I made some mistakes. We're all good. I'm sorry, Faster Peach. Peace. Jesus, I can't read anymore. Faff, I shall call you. I keep forgetting to check Twitch chat because I'm a terrible streamer. Also, Keys, I keep getting distracted by being very bad at this game. I hope you're doing well, though. Right. Let's keep sneaking. Here we go. Hi.
Hey, you got him.
Sure did.
Put it down in the hall.
Oh, were you his?
Good job. Take this.
I won't ask you why you needed that. So how do I get to Attermeyer?
I just sent one of my boys to turn off the power to the carriage rails. When the juice is off, you can walk along the rails and get where you need to go. On the other side, there's a station that will take you to Attermeyer.
Better than nothing. Thanks for your help.
Oh, you're so cool. And I got an achievement for that too. Right. Room down there that I shall attempt to get. Way to do that. Alt.
Don't hurt me.
No.
What?
You like coming to me?
I'm not gonna hurt you.
We're playing dice tonight. Are you in?
Nah, not this time.
Okay.
Your face is covered. Are you worried someone might recognize you? To someone usual gossip over dinner.
I don't think so.
Okay.
If only truth and justice could really be weighed on scales.
It doesn't say that, it says Brinley and Finch.
Let's organize an outing.
Well, pray tell. The fuck? Do I get to that room?
Let's ask the land agent to re-inspect the riverside drain.
Ah, I know. Hop in the river and swim. That's what I'm messing up. Just a little chunk of yeet. Ouch. Let's see if I'm remembering correctly. No. Right. Gonna look this up because clearly I don't know. There's also an art that I want. I'll probably do that in my own time. Okay. Okay. Right. I see. There we go. How many do I have? 4, right. I'm gonna upgrade this. That's always good. Then, 1, E, dope. I'm like way past the area where I can pick up the painting, so never mind that. God, it's good for some, eh?
More Grand Guard soldiers. Best to avoid.
Don't maybe search the whole place. I don't have time for that.
What, pray tell? Need to be more sneakier. As it were. Really annoyed that I didn't get that painting. I wish I'd read about it when I first got in, but I opened the guide slightly too late. Oh well, that's just how it be. I could probably actually pick up the rest of them, then just load that, like, save, and then... No, don't worry about it.
Now the power's down.
I could transfer you to the Dust District if you're looking for
more Grand Guard soldiers. Best to avoid.
Why do we even need Grand Guard personnel? Adamire Institute has strategic value to the Duke's inner circle. That's all I was told. You know how it works.
Rush, we just carry out your orders. I get it.
Go. Sneaky, sneaky. I'm working so late these days, so might as well sleep out of my... I know it's not good for my health, and a doctor should know better. You're totally right. I have the feeling I'm about to discover something important, something that will improve my Adamar solution. Would you be so kind as to water my plants for a few days? You do a better job than me anyway. I always forget them. Help yourself to unlock some of my reserve if you like. I hope Caroline gets better soon. Friend and neighbor. Right.
Welcome to Winslow Safes. Feel free to have a look around.
Thanks for not immediately threatening to kill me, dude.
I have to tell myself that fixing all this will bring back prosperity.
72. We're gonna keep running a safe contest. Maybe no one comes into shop, or maybe a dozen people come in, like we had during the Parade of Fishmongers 5 years ago. I promise, none of the thick dots, gods, dock workers, or their coarse wives are gonna guess a combination. We just won the contest to bring people into the shop, and if we're lucky, they talk about it over beers with their friends at family dinners. See, they don't know what's inside, they fill it with banks. They imagine something's granted to treasure reserves at Dumbledore Tower. We need the business, so keep the signs up and stay polite to the knuckleheads to try to open the safe. Doop, 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 doop. It takes so long to wind these sometimes. I could have guessed it. No, I couldn't actually. It would take me so long to guess it. Thanks, dude. Right. New bone charm. We got the one. So let's go forward. Charity. Could do that. The corrupted bone charms are cool, but not super my jam. In other news,
Adamire Station.
Fuck
this
me.
Should take me out to the Institute.
In other news, I'm an idiot and who can't hit the right buttons. And he doesn't pay attention to where they're going. At least I got the improved dark vision though, so that's a bit better. Right. Let's, as they say, not go that way. Is there anything up here? Sure as shit then. Right. This way then. I do want to go upstairs though, just to see what's up here. You know, you never know. Some secrets were meant to be told. Nothing. Cool. Love all the paintings here. Very cool.
This must be the alchemist's apartment. Alexandria Hypatia.
Sorry. Just constant need to pick thing up.
The blood flies have flourished with all the Duke's executions.
I spend less and less time here at my apartment, but my work at Adamire demands it. After the horrible failures of my first serum.
Adamire Station. This should take me out to the Institute.
Shut up, I'm listening to this.
Comfort to their families. It's my obsession, this work, and the impact it will have
Oops, okay. I've always believed the idea of Bloodline Nest Keepers to be legend or drunken Manitok, even though members of the Grand Guard have reported putting down belligerent occupants when burning out Bloodfly infestations. As such, the Silvergraph represents a rare sighting. We can only conclude that the final stage of Bloodfly Fever occasionally results in an extraordinary kind of brain damage, when the hosts fixate on protecting the nests. The Bloodflies in turn welcome the afflicted person, and thus a symbiotic relationship results. Bloodfly research never ceases to amaze. If we could procure a sample from the brain of one of these Nest Keepers, I'd love to observe the effects on rats or wolfhounds in my lab. Gross. Nice. Okay. Anything else? Listen to her talk about the solution. Right, F5. It's time to get us away over there. Why are we walking so loudly? Jesus.
Someone there?
Nope. Whomst? Whomst? Here we go.
Oh my. Is that my breath I'm smelling? Maybe my teeth are due for their monthly cleaning.
Price.
Nerves a shot. Something unsafe going on.
Sure is, my good dude. Goodbye. Nice. I got spotted once, but we did get clean hands. We got all the runes, both shrines, bone charms. One of four paintings, that's okay. Explore the save contest. Snatched a body. And examined Hypatia's Institute. I will... I'll pick up the paintings in my own time, I think. Eliminate the Crankle who's been murdering your enemies to make you look guilty. Find your old ally, Anton Sokolov, last seen being carried towards Adamaya. Alexander Hypatia, he runs the place, should know more. God, it loads so slowly. I know it's because I set the graphics up high, but I can handle it, and I like.
The Adermeyer Institute of Infectious Disease. Alexandria Hypatia, chief alchemist. Once it was a solarium for recuperating aristocrats. Now it's a place of alchemical study. The Crown Killer's taking lives in my name and has to be stopped. It's my hope that Hypatia can explain. They say she's brilliant and altruistic. Well respected across Cirkonos.
Yeah, she is. G. She has other things too, but we'll talk about those later. But folks, it is just past 11 o'clock and we've reached a pretty good end point, so I am going to end things off here. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. It is very much appreciated and I do hope that you enjoyed. Why is my music not playing? Pretzel, why you gotta play me this way? There we go, Jesus. I will be streaming. I just realized, oh, piss, that's annoying. I will be streaming. Tomorrow is Destiny 2 Day. We will be starting the Season of the Forge. Then on Tuesday it'll be Final Fantasy XIV, where we will be continuing the story of Shadowbringers on Ashard, following the Yulmoran attack on the Crystarium. Thursday we'll be Higurashi Rin the Quiet, Tatari Goroshi, where we shall probably continue to skive off school and start working towards freeing our friend from the clutches of her horrible uncle. And then next Saturday will be more Dishonored 2, where we are going to investigate the Adamaya Institute and search out for the Crown Killer. So take care, everybody, have a wonderful afternoon, do look after yourselves, do take care, and I shall see you guys tomorrow.